The Coalition of Northern Groups, CNG, has reacted to the arrest of Yoruba freedom fighter Sunday Adeyemo, popularly known as Sunday Igboho. In a statement issued by the coalition spokesman, Abdulaziz Sulaiman, the group urged the Nigerian government to immediately expose sponsors of groups clamoring for self-determination in the southern part of Nigeria. The group warned that the arrest of Igboho and that of Nnamdi Kanu, leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, should not be taken as the end of the uprising and disturbance over self-determination. CNG said Igbo's arrest should serve as a lesson to followers who are instigated into setting fire to their own backyards, whereas the instigators of such lawlessness and violence almost all the time have a fallback option that includes escaping abroad. The statement reads, "From the onset, we wish to be categoric that the arrest of Igboho and Kanu should not be mistaken as bringing about the end to the uprisings and disturbance over self-determination perpetrated by southern Nigerian elites and government who use talks like Igboho and Kanu. We insist that rather than seeing the arrest as an end in itself, it should be the beginning of the processes for self-determination by any unit that wants to go. Therefore, we insist on a peaceful referendum for separation from a people who would at the slightest and pretext attack, kill and destroy people of other regions and their properties, especially those from the north. The arrest of Igboho is government business, and as long as it conforms with the principle of rule of law and international crime justice procedures, we are not yet sure that he is going to be charged with, but expectedly incitement of violence against northerners would be one of them. We all know that threats of violent succession anywhere as a grave offense that no man, no government can condone. From records of history, it is only northern Nigeria that has not called for the breakup of the country at the slightest of pretense. With the arrest of Kanu and now Igboho, we are hoping that government will go beyond prosecution to digging up and exposing their sponsors and the agenda behind them. While Kanu's case may be attributed to some form of insanity which was exploited by the Southeast elites, who were playing cards, they were playing a double game. Igboho is a deliberate and calculated, supported and encouraged attempt by the Yoruba leaders, including their government, to scare the North into agreeing to secede power without competition. Unfortunately, they took it too far by arming Igboho and setting him against law-abiding citizens from other regions, particularly the North. The arrest, if considered along with that of Kanu, should serve as a lesson to those behind followers who were instigated into setting fire to their own backyards, whereas the instigators of such lawlessness and violence almost all the time have a fallback option that includes escaping abroad. The two arrests also attest to the level of cross-regional cooperation that is working across Africa. What is your thought about this that has been said? What is your own reaction to this present situation? We have had the Coalition of Northern Group, CNG, who have reacted to the arrest of Yoruba freedom fighter Sunday Adeyemo, who is popularly referred to as Sunday Igboho. What is your thought about this? According to the news, the group warned that the arrest of Igboho and that of Nnamdi Kanu should not be taken as the end of the uprising and disturbances over self-determination. We now expect Buhari government we now, you know, expose the southern elite that is sponsoring Kanu Igboho. That is what the northern groups have been saying, that by, you know, with this present development, with this present arrest, by now the president of Nigeria should dig deep and expose those elites, you know, those southern elites that is sponsoring Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igboho. What is your thought about this? We'd like you to share your own point of view with us on this present situation. Like you to share your own reaction via the comment section on this that has been said. But before we go, let's see people's reactions and know their thoughts about this. Let's see what people have felt concerning the present situation of things in Nigeria. Top scene, Itohuwo reacted to this and said, "Is there any crime in sponsoring or supporting agitators? Self-determination is not a crime and would never be. 98% of Biafrans support Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and 98% of Yorubas support Igboho. To hell with those who speaks against them. May God bless and protect Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igboho. Surely they must succeed." That is what Topsin have said. What is your own thought about this? What is your own reaction to this present situation? We have heard Topsin saying, "Is there any crime in sponsoring or supporting agitators? After all, self-determination is not a crime, and it will never be a crime. So if, though people are supporting or sponsoring these agitators, they are sponsoring what is not a crime. So if you say you want to start digging deep about these people who are sponsoring them, we have 98% of Biafrans who are supporting Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Tell me, how do you want to investigate 98% of Biafrans? And on the same hands, we have 98%, you know, of the Yoruba people who are also supporting Igboho. So how do you want to investigate this? To hell with those who are speaking against these two people. To hell with them. May God bless and protect Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igboho, because it is certain they must succeed." That is what Topsin have said. What is your thought about this? If the president Muhammadu Buhari is saying that he wants to continue to dig deep to know those who are sponsoring these two activists, then I hope Buhari will now expose those sponsoring Boko Haram, banditry, and Fulani herdsmen in this country. What am I even saying, safe? How can the government, you know, who is sponsoring the above criminality, investigate itself? Is it possible? When you are the one sponsoring something, we are the one sponsoring evil act, sponsoring criminality in your own country, will you investigate yourself again? How is that possible? But it is obvious that you cannot investigate these people, because we have millions of people supporting them. What is your thought about this? Both home and abroad, they have supporters. I would like you to drop your thought and reaction on this that has been said. Thank you guys for listening. Do subscribe to this channel if you have not, and I'll see you on the other news. Bye for now.